Fool around, to putter aimlessly, waste time. She fooled around all through school. What might we find you doing if you were indulging yourself in puttering aimlessly, Lloyd?
Certainly not lying more than lying, huh?
It's funny you should mention that. I had that experience Saturday morning at the Area A1 speech contest. Several of you were there, Mary and Vicki and Christina and Eric and Joe was there also. And I hadn't slept much at all the previous two nights because my wife had some dental surgery and had a very bad reaction to the anesthesia they used. So I was kind of wrecked when I got up to give my speech. And I got off. I got the first two sentences out and lost the thread for a second. But rather than just power through, I stood there in stunned silence. And then I went on. But I veered down the wrong path because, see, there are nine versions of that speech, nine revisions. And I veered off under one of the earlier ones. And when I realized what I had done, I thought, what the hell am I going to do now? Now, I could have just stopped, I guess, but that looks bad at a contest. So I just kept going, and I rewrote about a minute of it in my head, just a fraction of a second before I was saying the words. Now, if you want to feel a certain amount of stress, go ahead and do that. But I've done a lot of contests and a lot of other speaking, too, and so I can do it. But not when I'm wrecked. Anyway, I finally finished. The end of it, as those of you who were there, was quite a bit better than the beginning had been. But when I sat down, I actually thought I was about to pass out from having put myself through that aimless wandering around. And I really thought, I'm the luckiest guy in the world because there are no other contestants here. Steve would have crushed me if he had given the speech that he gave a couple of weeks ago and I closed me. So in terms of aimless wandering around, that's pretty much it. And after the contest, I went home and just sat there and kind of stared for the rest of the day.